Hello everyone, this is a lecture exclusively for the students of Cost Accountants of India, intermediate level. We are discussing operations management and strategic management subject in that. This is chapter 4, production planning and control. Under that we are now looking at the topic simulation. Simulation, or to simulate, is to create a model. A mathematical model. In this case, for the purpose of business, we are going to create a model. So whenever you have random outcomes, random, there is no pattern to it. It can change randomly. So whenever you have random outcomes, you may want to use simulation to guess what would be the number we can see the next day. Suppose your sales is all random. Number of units you sell is completely random. Some days you sell 200 units, some days 300 units. The outcomes are random. Then you may use simulation to guess what would be my sales for the next day. So you need to use random numbers to guess the sales for the next day. So this we'll discuss with a problem. I have some data here, number of units of sales, 200, 250, 300, so on and so forth. Number of days this has happened in the past 500 days. The businessman has taken historical data and is giving you this, saying that some days I sell 50 units, some days 75 units, and so on and so forth. So in the past 500 days, he's giving you data. Your problem may have sales and days, or it may also give you sales and probability directly instead of giving number of days. So if they don't give you probability, you just calculate probability 50 by 500, which is the value for that particular outcome divided by total possible outcomes. So 50 out of 500, 10%. 75 out of 500, 15%, and so on and so forth. So once you have the probabilities, the next step, before going to the next step, so 10% probability means out of 100 chances, or say there are 100 lottery tickets, in 10 tickets you write 200. Because it has a 10% chance. Based on my historical data, 50 days out of 500 days, the sales was 200. So you create a raffle or lottery tickets and put 200 in 10 tickets because it has 10% chance. Similarly, for in 250 sales, there is a probability of 15%. So you have to give 15 chances for 250. 15 tickets you write 250. And finally, after writing all these numbers, you shuffle and take one chit out. That is the random outcome. So you write 200 in 10 chits, 250 in 15 chits, 320 chits, and so on, 405 chits. Totally 100 chits you have written. So based on historical data, you are arriving at probabilities. And then you shuffle it and take one chit out of it to find out what will be my sales for tomorrow. That is what you are doing. Instead of writing it on a chit, you want to do mathematically with the help of random numbers. So you need 100 chits. So we need to allocate 100 numbers to these outcomes. So for that, let's find out cumulative probability. So cumulative probability, 10% for the first one. Together, it's 25%. For the first three, together, it is 45%, and so on. Now you need hundred sheets or hundred numbers. It should have equal chance of being picked. So let's go to this random number table, which you will find in a logbook. You can have any random number. So if you look at it, if you want two digit numbers, 100 numbers, you will start picking like this: 36, 51, 83, 67, 77, 89, 11, 60, or you can go downwards also: 36, 46, 31, 84, 78, and so on. If you want random numbers, you can pick it from the random number table in a normal logbook. So we need 100 sheets or 100 numbers. So we'll start from 00 to 99. If you look at here, is there a chance of a 00? There could be 00. See here, 21, 16, the next number is 00. 00 also has an outcome, chance of getting a 00. So two digit numbers starting from 00 to 99. So you go to the random number table, pick two digit numbers. Because the outcome is random, there is no pattern to this outcome. That's why you are using random numbers. Now, cumulative probability, random number range. Random number range, first 10 numbers from this 100 numbers. So you have 100 numbers here, 00 included, up to 99, 100 numbers. The first 10 numbers are given to outcome 200 units. Then you need next 15 numbers given to 250, because it has a 15% probability. So next 15 numbers, 10 to 24. If you count, you will see that it is 10 to 24. So that is the next set. So how do I find out this range quickly? So 00 to the one number before 10, 9. And then from 9, the next number is 10. 10 to one number before the cumulative probability value for that row, 24. So 25 to 44, 45 to 69, 70 to 84. So we're just ending one number before this. 85 to 94, 95 to 99. So you have the random number ranges. Now, this is the preparation of the problem. To find the sales for the next 10 days or 15 days, whatever you want, you can do. The problem will normally ask you to find out for 10, 15 days. So let's do it for 12 days maybe. We need to know the random number. So we'll use the random number table, or Excel also has a function rand between 00, 99. For every hit, it keeps changing. I pasted it as values because if I retain it as a formula, it keeps changing. And then I'm changing the format so that the 9 becomes 09. So now we have 12 random numbers. You could also pick from the random number table. You could have picked 36, 51, 83, 67, and so on. Or as I said, column wise, you can pick two digit numbers, but we have taken Excel's help. Now the sales forecast. What will be the sales for 48. If it's 48, it is between 45 and 69. So my sales is going to be 320 units. Then the next ticket number is 87. 87 is given to 350. So my second day sales is going to be 350. Next number is 91. Again, 91 is in this range. So ticket 91 also belongs to 350. Next is 41. 41 ticket belongs to sales 300. So 300 is the sales here. 26 again belongs to 300. 50 is 320. 96 is 400. Then 48 is 320. 35 is 300. 09 is 200. And then 17 is 250. And finally, 33 is 300. So we have the sales for the next 12 days using random numbers. So this is the simulation part. After this, you may have a financial part. What is the financial part? Now, the seller asks you, I cannot keep changing my inventory like this. Some days 200, some days 320. I want to have constant inventory. So tell me how many units should I stock? Ideal units to stock is the question. Options, say 250 or 350. Assume that he says, let's stock 250 or 350 units. I can constantly have that units. But there is a challenge. If you stock less and there is more demand, you'll have opportunity loss. If a customer comes and asks you for a product and you don't have it, then the opportunity loss is, say, 20 rupees. And if you have more and the demand is less, you may have scrap sale loss. Assume that you have to scrap it at the end of the day. It's perishable. So you're buying fruits and selling it. So you have to scrap it. And if you scrap, you lose, say, 15 rupees. And there is a normal profit. Your normal profit per unit is, say, 30. So you make a profit of 30 per unit. And if you have excess stock, you have to scrap it at a loss of 15 rupees. You throw away units, you lose 15 rupees. And if a customer comes and asks you for your product and you don't have it, then there is an opportunity loss of 20 rupees. So these three information are given. Now I need to find out, what if I stock 250 units, second option 350 units, and then find out which is best. So as I said, simulation part is over with this. Now, if I have 250 units, what happens? I have a stock of 250 units. I'll write it here. What will be my sales when I have a stock of 250 units? This is not sales. This is going to be the demand. for the next 15 days. Based on my historical data, I have randomly guessed what could be the demand for the next 15 days. Actual sales, if I stock only 250 units, my sales can only be 250. So do I have any unsold inventory at the end of the day? Nothing. Opportunity loss or unmet demand. Somebody comes and asks me, can you sell? 320 people came and asked me that day. I had only 250 units. So I couldn't meet 70 people's demand. So my profit for the day, 250 units sold into 30 rupees profit minus any unsold unit, I lose 15 rupees minus any unmet demand or opportunity loss of 20. So that day's profit is 6,100. Though my true profit is 30 rupees, 250 times 30, 7,500. But my net profit is only 6,100. So the following day, again, my stock is only 250. So I sell 250. No unsold units. I have 100 extra demand, unmet demand. So my profit is only 5,500. Now the following day, I sell again only 250. Let's write it as a formula. 250 or actual demand, whichever is minimum. I can only sell that. Here alone, I'm selling 200. Rest of the cases, I'm selling 250. Any unsold units? I have 50 unsold units here. Otherwise, no unsold units anywhere. See, I'm not writing the accurate formula. I'm just trying to get to the answer. And since all these are zeros, I'm finding out what is my opportunity loss in all these cases. Here alone, there is no opportunity loss. And these two cases, again, I have some opportunity loss. In this case only, we have 250 units demand, 250 sales, no unsold stock, no opportunity loss. So we have the formula here. So you have to do it with your calculators carefully. So your total profit for the next 12 days is equal to 72,550. This is at 250 units. Let's look at what if it's 350 units. So before that, I'll write down. Stock of 250 units. My profit was 72,550. For stock of 350 units, if my stock is changed to 350, I can sell minimum of the actual demand or 350 units. I've sold it. Any unsold units? I have the actual sales here. So unsold will be 350 minus this So I don't have unsold units on some days. And unmet demand would be demand minus sales. Only one day I had 400 units demand and 350 units in stock. Okay. The rest of the days, my stock was more because I had 350 units. I ended up with excess unsold stock. So with that, you have the calculations. I sold 320 units, so 320 times 30 minus unsold stock into 15 rupees minus unmet demand into 20 rupees. So I've done the calculations already, the formula. So my profit is going to be. So your recommendation as a consultant for the small business is the company or the shop must stock 350 units to maximize the profit. If they have 250, they'll end up making total profit of 72,550. Whereas at 350 units, their profit goes up to 1,700,000. So there are some textbook problems where you may have doubts as to how these are arrived at. So probably in the next session, I'll look. Take you through those problems, one or two problems, and explain how or why they've done that. That will help you during your preparation. Thank you all. If you have any doubts, you know how to reach me. Bye-bye.